point in.
My father's mother.
Mm-hmm. The Baba Chaya.
Baba Chaya.
Okay. Who is this?
And that's her husband. But it's not... well, you have to look at this picture of him and also...
Which picture?
Here.
Ah, this one. And?
This one. And you have to look at this other one. Wait. Where is it? Up there.
Up there.
It's the same man at a different age.
Right.
And on the right is my mother.
Oh, I remember her very well, just like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But my mother always, wherever we moved, she had those two pictures. Because she said that whoever came from Europe, they all looked alike. They had the same beard, the same mustache, the same haircut. And you had to know who it was because they all looked the same. And this is me. And we used to say, mm-hmm. I remember that chair. Because you didn't have, mm-hmm. It's not that I remember this picture. But we used to say, my grandfather's friend from Europe was a photographer. So when he came here, he had a business. And everybody who had a kid, they never said we're going to get pictures.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to Dushman. And everyone knew Dushman. And in those days, if a guy worked in leather, it was a low calling. And if he had, like a shoemaker, was a low calling. But when he was a photographer, he was already a bigger
mm-hmm.
person. And we never said we're getting pictures made. We always said we're going to Dushman.
That's right. Do you have a picture of you and Maish at your wedding?
Sure.
But is it on the wall?
No, I have a book right here.
Okay.
But maybe you could take a picture.
Yeah.
And
then I better call. Taxi, yeah. Do they usually come right away?
Yeah.
Ah. So I'll take the picture and then we'll call. Ah. What is this picture? Wait, whoever. What is this picture, Phyllis?
This is our picture. I was dressed in white, and he was dressed in a white jacket. And this,
what year was that, Phyllis?
1948.
Do you remember what month?
June. You couldn't get married except 2 weeks. So everybody picked the first week because
and only, what is that?
Only on the first week
mm-hmm.
you could have time to go on a honeymoon. Mm-hmm. So I met a couple in Florida, introduced by
mm-hmm.
not Troy, but somebody through her, who were married the exact same day as we were, because they also picked the first week, so the second week that you could get married, we had a honeymoon week. And here's Yosha David.
Where?
Yosha David and Badana. And that's me.
That's right, I have a copy.
That's me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's me in Dushman's mm-hmm. chair.
And this?
And this was on the side of the house in Passaic.
Another house?
I don't know, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Remember that one? That's a famous one.
Yeah.
You know,
this. Yeah. I have one mm-hmm. up there, too.
How did you meet Meshke?
Brooklyn College.
Tell me the minute you first saw him. Kuk auf mir, kuk nicht auf dem Buch.
I wanted to see another picture.
Uh-huh. So where in Brooklyn College?
In the library.
Ooh, what were you doing in the library?
Reading.
What was he doing in the library?
Well, that's what my mother wanted to know. Well, she said, how come you're spending so much time in the library? And I said, don't you want me to be passing everything? So she said, yeah, but so much time? Well, it was because I was from the group of girls who traveled from the Bronx to Brooklyn every day. And there were a few of us, and the reason he took me out is I think Joe gave him a pair of tickets to something. And
Joe gave him a pair of tickets without knowing that he met someone or that he would meet someone, of course.
I have no idea it was.
Joe didn't know you.
No one knew me. So
how did he see you in the library? What happened in the library?
He had the tickets.
So he was looking for someone? So
the reason he asked me was that I lived in the Bronx across the way from the Manhattan side of that area. And if he took me home, it was just a walk across the bridge. If he took a girl from Brooklyn home, he'd have to go down to Brooklyn and have to come back.
And on Shikinish.
So
you have your Bronx abode to thank for that. Just imagine had you been a Brooklyn girl.
That would have been it.
That would have been it. You see what good luck you have.
Yeah, look at this.
And he.
This was from a Halloween party. That's what we were in, dressed up in.
Mm-hmm. Phyllis, that's a wonderful story about the tickets. So that was in 1948.
47.
And what were the tickets for?
Some kind of play.
A play. And where was the play?
In Manhattan.
And you don't remember the play. You remember the boy, but not the play.
Who cares about the play? Here.
If had the play not worked out, who knows if this would have worked?
Well,
how long did it take till your second date?
I don't remember that.
Was it closer to a day or a week?
I don't know.
We try. Okay. Blessing, if we can pass. What did you like about him?
Come on. You can't say that.
No?
These years later.
You can ask how it seemed that first time.
No, it cannot.
Well.
This was a picture in Coney Island, Brighton.
Phyllis, sit down. Sit down.
If I don't sit down...
Sit down here. That's a chavek.
If I don't sit down, I'll fall down.
Sit down. Right here is a beautiful chair. And blessings are going to help you.
Yeah.
You're blessed with a blessing. What a great name. Broche in Yiddish. Do you remember your grandparents well, Phyllis?
Yes.
Could you say a few words about them?
No.
No?
Oh, look at this picture. Hank and Doris. You remember them.
Very well.
And here's a picture of them. Hank and Doris here.
Did they live in Great Neck? No. No? Where did they live?
Well, this is in our house, in the hall in our house. We had a cat, but she was out in the garage. And this is me and my mother.
Could you tell me again about the one who was the yeshiva bocha?
Yeah, this is my father, my mother, and me. in that picture. Mm-hmm. And the one on the left is from in Brighton or Coney Island on the beach. Okay, what else am I supposed to tell you?
About your grandparents.
Oh.
Only what you want to tell me.
Yeah, wait a minute, I'm looking at this now. This is... And Mesh, must have been a bar mitzvah picture. No?
Could be.
I think so. And this was a picture of...
On the Mayflower.
Yeah, of course.
In Coney Island.
Yeah. This was Mesh, Badana, and Menke. This must have been a bar mitzvah picture, no?
Met Meshka till when you got married.
A couple of years, anyway.
A couple of years?
Yeah.
That's a long time.
Well, everybody in Brooklyn walked around like this.
What's mentos?
It means you gotta look at my diamond ring.
Ah.
I didn't have a diamond ring.
Right.
I had a watch.
Uh-huh.
Which I couldn't wear because it was so small a face that I couldn't see the numbers. And I don't know where it is. It is somewhere, but I don't know where. The only thing is, finally, we've been paying for the bank vault, and I asked, I couldn't do David on it, because he was already, he had a grant on the Kellett Fellowship to go to Oxford. So I have Alan and Michael on the vault. So I gave a key. I had two keys. And I signed them both on. And I told them I gave them only one key because it's very expensive to get another key because you have to go through all kinds of things. And I said, I want you to go and empty whatever's in there. Whatever is there, because I don't know what's there. I have an idea of some things.
When was this?
What do you mean?
When did you ask them to do that?
Oh, I don't know. 2 years ago.
Okay.
Because I had the keys.
Sure.
And Alan said, look, it's only Alan and Michael on it. Because David Ruddy was gone in Europe and he was in England then, and so since he wasn't around, because you usually take oldest next, so I couldn't do that. So I gave it to Alan, and Alan said, look, I'm not promising right away because I have no time to just go into a vault now, because he was really busy too. Between, he was getting married and he was getting all kinds of work. And he went to law school. And it was really something that everybody was running in circles. This chair was my grandfather's with the table behind it. And it's so fragile that I don't let anyone sit on it. And I had one of these guys here put another backing underneath so that nobody would put anything on the chair because it couldn't take the weight. And there's a big chair in the bedroom, stronger, and we had two of them. So my grandmother had one in her house and my mother had one. This was also from my grandfather, because when they moved, they took the...
Oh. Blessing?
Where's the phone? Pick it up. Pick it up. Hello.
Hello? You gotta press something?
Yeah, press stop.
Where?
Just a minute.
Green button.
Oh, yeah, I don't know anything.
Hello?
Yeah.
My grandfather used to do certain things. He never wanted a congregation. He says, because then you're beholden to the richest man. And it's horrible. He runs your life. Mm. So he didn't want that. But he also used to know how to blow shofar. And we had one in the house. What happened to it? I don't know. I think maybe David got it. But somebody got it. And it was in the house for a long time, in my house. And I just don't remember now. A lot of things I don't remember. So, and the picture up there is my father and my mother. Yeah. And I don't know when it was. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And that one is
here she's driving. Right. And I never knew till today that you are Sora Fagel. It's a beautiful name. And it's a rare combination together.
Is it?
Yeah. Of course, how many Sora Fagels have you ever heard of?
None.
None.
But my friend Doris used to tease me. Because she would look at the picture. She wasn't a beautiful woman. I have a picture here of her. And so she used to say, you were named for that great beauty?
You should have answered, sie ist gewann a sach schöner wie auf dem Bild.
No.
She was much more beautiful than on the picture.
But I always said what my grandfather said to me, which was, she was his schwieger. And he used to say, when I grow up, his wish for me was, and he believed it, that I would be as well-loved and well-respected and admired by everybody and respected by everybody because she was such a wonderful person. And that was his schwieger. And
fantastic.
He always thought that she was such a wonderful person, and his only wish for me was to grow up to be as good as she.
And what more do you know about Sora Fager, for whom you were named?
I don't really know.
Where was she born, roughly when?
I know Vilna Gavrilovna, but I don't know anything else. Oh, wait a minute, just a minute. David knows with a SH. She... The town is...
Smargon?
No.
Oshmene.
Oshmene. Because Menke used to make the mistake and say Smargon. But it was
Oshmene.
Oshmene.
Yeah.
And when we were in Israel, I went to the museum there where you could trace your history. And we got a whole copy from my mother of Oshmene. And that was when they had... In Oshmina, the Milkiker, because we gave $200 to the guy who was the dairy man.
I remember.
To buy him a cow.
I was there with you.
All right. Mm. So I'm not lying.
I introduced you to him.
Whatever I'm telling
it's
you.
It was Tevye the Milkiker from Oshmina.
That's right.
Yeah. The Litvisha Tevye the Milchika.
Yeah.
And then when I wrote the article in the